guys, is carrying my review for the third installment of Into the Dark, Puka. And what Puka is essentially about is we center on the character of Wilson. He is someone who is very much a struggling actor, and he ends up getting this gig in this, in basically this toy commercial called Puka, and Puka ends up being immensely successful. It's basically the hottest toy of that Christmas season, essentially. But he also is trying to fall in love with this woman, and very quickly the lines between reality and fiction very much do start to blur for him, and that's really all I'm gonna say. So I know that I did not review the Thanksgiving iteration of Into the Dark. I meant to do that, but I just never got around to it. But that being said, I really wanted to watch the... It gave me even more of an urge to watch the Christmas one, and I was actually very excited to see how this was going to turn out. I enjoyed The Body, as you guys know. I didn't think it was absolutely incredible, but it felt like it was just a start. It felt like it was only going to get better as it went along, and I'm very happy to say, if Puka is what most of Into the Dark is going to be from here on out, I am definitely interested because I really adored Puka a lot. I think this is a very interesting film that really dives into some things that I was not expecting it to. It is much darker than some of the first Into the Dark, and I'm very interested in seeing where they end up going. You know, with Into the Dark from here on out, but I'm just getting into it right now, starting off with the cast. And right off the bat here, the cast is really great. I think everyone really does bring it here, but someone I really do want to focus on is Nyasha Hattendi as our main character here, Wilson, who is phenomenal in this role. I really haven't seen him in really anything, but I thought he absolutely killed it here. I loved what he did in the role of Wilson. Wilson is someone who you can see that he has a lot of anger bottled up inside of him, but he's trying to live this normal life. He's trying to be successful, and you see that he's doing whatever he can to be successful, but it is starting to have an effect on him, and I just thought he really killed it in this role. I really loved what he ended up doing here. There's, especially towards the third act, I mean, things just go absolutely bonkers for this guy, but he just really brings it as an actor, and I can't wait to see what he's gonna do next. I really did love him here a lot. And then Dale Dickey as well, as the character of Red, also very much stuck out to me. This is Wilson's neighbor, and these two have a very interesting sort of relationship. She kind of is like a maternal figure to him, but she's also kind of a friend, and I really enjoyed their relationship a lot. I thought she did a very good job here. She also has a very traumatic past, and I really did like getting more into that. I thought she also was very good here. As far as the rest of the cast goes, everyone else is really great. Latarsha Rose, as Wilson's main love interest, is very good here. I thought that she did a very good job of playing this woman who... You can tell that she really does love Wilson, but Wilson is someone who, he's a bit of a loose cannon. She never knows when he's going to go off, so while she does love him, she's very tentative with certain things, and I really enjoyed their relationship here. You know, John Daly was very good, Johnny Berryman, really this entire cast very much does bring it, and I think they're far better than the cast in The Body. I'm not comparing them, but I'm just saying, I think the cast here is much different. Here, and I really enjoyed them a lot. Now I really want to get to the directing and the writing, because that immediately is one of the things that stuck out to me here, because unlike The Body, I actually recognize this director. The director of this is Nacho Vigalondo, who, if you guys remember, this is the guy who did Colossal last year, one of the most unique and inventive films of last year, I think. It was just, it's very different, it's very out there, and Puka, he really gets to go into some bizarre territory. I mean, his style to this film is so great. I mean, you can just tell he just goes for it. And I love that about Vigalondo's directing. It's very hypnotizing in that way. And it's a film that I think could very much irritate some people, but I thought his style worked very well here. He's really getting into some real psychedelic stuff, and I really love the Nacho Vigalondo. He seems to be one of those directors that doesn't really care what you think of his films. He makes the kind of film that he wants, and I think he does a very good job of that. And moving forward, I'm very excited to see what Vigalondo ends up doing from here on out, because I thought his directing was just really, really well done. And again, some people might be a bit, you know, irritated by how disorienting it really is. But for me, I think it very much worked in that regard, and I really liked his directing here. But the writing is what I really want to get into, because this film is a very unique style to it. In many ways, this film is a modern retelling of A Christmas Carol, but not in the way that you would expect it to be. It's a much different type of story structure, and you really got to think about it for a little bit in how it actually is like A Christmas Carol, but it honestly really is. But like I said, it's just a very different film structurally, and I really enjoyed that a lot. I thought the writing here was very interesting with that, and I really did enjoy the style. But what I really love about this film is the story it's trying to tell of Wilson. I mean, this is just a guy who, he's been a really big actor before. He's someone who's had a lot of really big roles, and you see he's very much struggling, and he seems to be one of those guys who he just takes whatever is offered to him, even if it is something as ridiculous as just being in this costume and making these very simple hand movements, which there's this great sequence where they are teaching him basically how to be Pooka, and they're the most simplistic hand moves you could possibly think of, but they really drill it into him, and you'll probably be annoyed by the Pooka commercial, but that's very much the point. You see that this is something that it's definitely bottom of the barrel in terms of his career, but it's something that he is doing, and it ends up making him really successful. And I thought it was definitely a really great story. And the way that he's trying to balance that with his normal life with Latarsha Rose's character, Melanie, I thought was also really well done. You can see that he just wants this to be a normal relationship, but Pooka keeps getting in the way of that. Pooka keeps ruining a lot of things. There's a really great sequence where he wants to, you know, bring Pooka to entertain a bunch of kids at her son's birthday party, and it ends up going horribly wrong. But you see that he always does have his heart in the right place. You see that he really is trying to help her, but he seems to have these outbursts. There seems to be gaps in his mind that he keeps forgetting, and you're not entirely sure why. And I just thought overall it was a very well-written story. It does not go the way you think. They make it seem like at first that this is one of those, oh, the costume is like the villain, but that's really not what it is. Without getting too much into it, it's not that kind of film. It's not nearly as traditional as you might expect it to be, and that's really why I enjoy it as much as I did. But something else I really appreciate about Pooka is just the social commentary that is spread throughout this movie. The movie is very much saying a lot about the idea of consumerism and how this can really overtake an individual, and how fast Pooka ends up rising. I mean, very quickly Wilson ends up selling out. He is not famous because of who he is. He's famous because he wears a Pooka costume, and you see that these guys are really taking advantage of him. You know, they basically are turning him into this guy that just he's constantly doing the Pooka stuff, and it starts to change his sense of self. He starts to become like Pooka, and it's a very interesting sort of social commentary on just what modern consumerism and the kind of stuff that we're exposed to, and just how easy we are to fall for something. I mean, again, Pooka, there's really nothing that extraordinary about him. He does these four very simple hand movements, but children just eat it up, and it's a very modern representation of, I think, just modern consumerism. And I think the film has a lot of really great stuff to say about that, but it also has a lot to say about fame and how fame can overtake an individual and how that can be the sole thing they focus on. Because again, while Wilson is trying to focus on his relation with Melanie, you know, his need for fame and his need for being adored always seems to take precedent, always seems to come first. And I thought it was a really cool idea. I really loved where they end up going with that. And again, this is just, it's so much deeper than I really was expecting. And that's one of the things I really enjoyed about it a lot here. Also, in terms of cinematography, this thing is amazing. Some of the best of the entire year. There are some incredible shots here, just from the opening sequence in general. I mean, some of the best I've seen all year. It's so out there. It's just so bizarre, and I really loved the style to this film. And no point does it feel style over substance. It makes sense why this is happening, because Wilson is very much an unreliable narrator. There are certain gaps in his mind that he just kind of seems to leave out. And there are some things that do get very weird and bizarre, but I thought it was really well done, and I enjoy the cinematography a lot here. The score here, besides the Puka song, which, like I said, is extremely annoying and it's definitely not going to leave your head. I'm thinking about it right now as I'm recording this. And again, that's the film's intent. The film's intent is to annoy you with that song, is to make it feel repetitive, just to show how much of a chore this is becoming for Wilson, how much this is becoming like a regular occurrence for him, and how he can't really live without something as simple as this really dumb song. And I thought it worked very well here. But the score aside from that is really great, and I enjoy it a lot. And the editing, I will admit, if I had to have one issue, which I do have a couple issues with this, is that I do think that it was a little bit too short. It's very well paced for the most part, and unlike the first Into the Dark, which felt like a 40-minute special that was crammed into like 80 minutes, this actually has the opposite problem, where I think it could have been a little bit longer. I think there were certain sections that we could have dived into a bit more, and I think it would have paid off just a little bit more. Red, especially. Red disappears for a majority of the film, and I just wanted a little bit more into that relationship, and I think they could have done just a little bit more of that. But for the most part, the film is very well paced. Like I said, it's very messy, but it's appropriately messy, because again, Wilson does not have the most reliable memory, and I think it works very well in that regard. Now, in terms of flaws, besides the editing, which I already touched upon, my biggest issue with Puka, which it's not really a huge issue, it's not something that ruins the movie, there is this twist that takes place at the end of the film, and it is a very good twist, but it is kind of jarring, and it's a lot of things to maybe think about, and the way the film ends is really abrupt, and I think, considering how monumental the twist is, which it really recontextualizes the entire story, you're gonna be sitting there and thinking, what actually is happening in this story? What actually happened here? You know, what really was the main story? There were a couple things that they introduced in that twist that were just a bit unclear, and I think if dived into a little bit more, I would have liked to get a bit more insight into what was going on. I think they could have spent maybe 10 or 15 more minutes just kind of showing what was actually happening, because I just think the way the film ends, it just felt a little bit abrupt. And considering this is supposed to be like a modern retelling of A Christmas Carol, the way it wraps up especially, it just didn't feel as satisfying as I think they want it to be. And I think they could have done a bit of a better job with that, but really, other than that, Puka is a fantastic film. This is much deeper than I was expecting. It has some really well-written characters. It has some really good social commentary about consumerism and things like that. It also tells a really good, it's a familiar story, but it does something different with it that I think really does stick out here. It has some phenomenal cinematography, some really great direction from Nacho Vigalondo, and like I said, if this is what Into the Dark is going to be from here on out, which, by the way, this is not the only Into the Dark we're getting this month. We are getting a New Year's one on like December 28th, which I definitely will be covering as well. This is like a priority. Like, what started off as me kind of testing this out, seeing if it actually works, now I'm actually really interested. Now I'm really excited to see what other stories we can actually get from this, what other stories they can do. Because if they're like Puka, then I am definitely very much on board. I really enjoyed Puka a lot here. Like I said, it really is those few flaws that, you know, keep this thing from being absolutely amazing, but it definitely is something that I really enjoyed a lot. It's something that I definitely do want to see again, and it is something that I think you should definitely watch in the Christmas season, because it is something really different, and we don't get that a lot, and that's one of the things I really enjoyed about Puka. Puka is a very well-done film, and I am going to give this installment of Into the Dark Puka overall a B+. Definitely check this one out as soon as you can, guys. It is on Hulu now, and I don't think it's getting enough attention. I think this is a very well-done film, and it's definitely something that I want to see again soon. But that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoy it. Let me know what you guys thought of this movie overall, of your thoughts, and we'll see you guys in my next video, and we'll see you guys for that. Okay, bye. Moving on.